be doing something very simple and hopefully make lots of nice, relaxing sounds. So for this activity, we need a nice, sturdy, hard surface. We are going to make this. It's a paper crane, and it is made out of paper. You can get special paper that has a nice, colorful pattern on the side, or you can use regular paper that's cut into a square. This is representing a crane. He has a neck and a little head, two wings, a body, and a long tail. So, let's make one of these together. So I have some plain red origami paper. I've had this particular paper for a long time. So it is very thin. A little crinkly. Just feels very smooth. We are going to move the paper to a diamond. And we are going to fold . So let's start by folding the bottom up to the top. very important that the corners and the sides match for every fold that you do. It needs to be as perfect as you can get it. I like to take something that's, you know, a little harder, just go over my creases, just to make sure they're really good. Also do this with your fingernail if you would prefer, as long as it's nice and crisp, crisp, crisp. Now I have a nice fold right down the center. And now we will do it to the other side. We'll take the bottom and we'll bring it to the top and we'll make another fold. This will create a nice X pattern. And I'll run my pen across, just to create a really nice crease, making sure it's nice and crisp. There, we have a nice X pattern. And now we are going to fold the other direction again. So with the X facing you upright, going to line up the best we can and we'll just make sure the lines are nice and crisp. And we'll do the same thing on the other side. Lining up those corners really well. there. Now we have a nice shape here. We're going to bring these sides together. Making sure that they match up really well at the bottom. So I like to kind of crease on the inside and match at the bottom first before I make the creases on this side and this side. There we go. And once again, I'm going to take my sturdy object and really make sure those folds. There we go. So we'll have a nice diamond shape once again. But there's going to be two flaps. And then a part that opens on the bottom. And this part will not open, okay? Alright. So, with the bottom part facing you, and the part that does not open facing away from you, we're gonna start our next fold. There we go. And I'm really going to crease this one nice. And then we'll do the other side as well. And we're only doing this to one layer. There's a top layer and a bottom. There we are. So we have kind of a nice, like, ice cream cone shape here. Cone part and the top. So now we're gonna fold the ice cream part over. There we go. And we'll bring it open. And with those nice folds we've just done, we're gonna kind of open it up. and kind of let those come backwards. So again, make sure everything is really aligned before you do too many hard creases. So we have nicely aligned corners. So we'll go ahead and grab our pen again. And I'll smooth them out. And then I'm going to fold that ice cream cone part down. Again. And that will allow us to do the kind of backwards fold. There we go. We have another nice diamond shape. Now, we're going to fold these once again. So I'm going to take one side of the paper. And I'm going to fold it one more time to the center. Taking care to make sure they are aligned. This part is a little more tricky. Some of those folds get very tight. One side, and now we'll do the other side. So now we will flip it over to the other side, and we will repeat that process one more time. Fold the paper. Just fold it very carefully. And I think we'll do the final crease after we have this one in place. And then we'll fold them inside and bend downward to make a little beak for the head. And I'm going to fold him down just a little bit. And then the same for the other side for the tail. Open it a little bit. And upward. And bring the wings back. There we go, and then we have our wings, which we will bend down, and then on the other side, okay, so right now our crane is very flat, we have a nice little bump here, some people just leave it like that, if you take the corner in the front and the opposite corner in the back and you just pull, it kind of opens up, and then you shift to the other corners, opposite corners, and you pull, and you just repeat that a couple of times until you're satisfied with the way it looks. But there you go. A beautiful paper crane. I think there is a legend or a story somewhere I've heard where if you fold 1,000 paper cranes, you get a wish. I'd have to look that up again. It's been a long time since I heard that, but it's kind of a neat idea. I really like when people fold very tiny paper cranes, but this is probably one of the smaller sizes that I would personally fold. I wouldn't consider myself very good at origami. I've dabbled in flowers, and a few other items. I can make the little lucky stars, but it's mostly for fun. Thank you for joining me. Good night.